वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर स्मिता शर्मा एंड टुडे वील डिस्कस लीनियर एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ एन ऑपरेशनल एम्पलीफायर। सो फर्स्ट द टॉपिक्स कवर्ड इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर व बेसिकली वी हैड डिस्कस्ड फ्रीक्वेंसी रिस्पॉन्स ऑफ एन ऑपरेशनल एम्पलीफायर इन डिटेल। हाउ डज द ऑपरेशनल एम्पलीफायर बिहेव्स व्हेन फ्रीक्वेंसी चेंजेस, what happens to its gain, and all this were discussed. Now today we'll discuss the applications of operational amplifier, rather we can say the linear applications of the operational amplifier. So in this linear application we'll discuss how operational amplifier can act as a DC amplifier, how it can act as an AC amplifier, can we make summing, scaling or averaging amplifier, because basically operational amplifier is given its name operational amplifier because it can perform mathematical operation electronically. So we'll see how operational amplifier making a suitable electronic circuit, how operational amplifier can be used as a summing amplifier or a subtracting amplifier or an averaging amplifier, if it can be used as an integrator for integration, for differentiation. All this we will see in this lecture and in coming lectures. So first of all we'll discuss the DC amplifier. So DC amplifier, we'll see the three diagrams. See, here in there are three diagrams, so we can say the DC amplifier can be made in three such ways as shown in the figure. In the first figure you can see the input is applied at the inverting end. In the second figure the input is connected at the non-inverting end, and in the third figure two signals are applied both at inverting and non-inverting end. So basically DC amplifier can be obtained in inverting configuration, non-inverting configuration and differential configuration. So basically operational amplifier can amplify both types of signals, DC and AC. So we are discussing DC. The DC amplifier, what do you mean by DC amplifier? The output signal changes in response to changes in its DC input levels. If DC input level changes, then the output signal also change according to the input signal. So this is the way basically DC amplifier. A DC amplifier, as you can see from all the three diagrams, can be inverting, non-inverting or differential. Now here it should be remembered that it is very necessary for good amplification that we reduce the output offset voltage to zero, and to improve accuracy of DC amplifier. The DC amplifier, in order to improve the accuracy of DC amplifier, first of all the output offset voltage should be zero. Now how this can be obtained? We have studied that there are two for in case of 741 that there are two points where a potentiometer should be connected in order to reduce the output offset voltage to zero or nullify this effect. So in such op-amps, here as shown in the diagram, the output offset null circuitry is used. Here all three diagrams you can see there are output offset null circuitry has been used. Now what will be the output of such an amplifier? So output we have discussed in detail and we'll just remember it the output is basically for an inverting amplifier is given by V naught is equals to minus RF upon R1, V input, and in non-inverting it is 1 plus RF upon R1 into V input, and for a subtractor circuit it is minus RF upon R1 V1 minus V2. So in this way the output can be calculated. Now here the output voltages that we had seen follow the same principle as we had discussed in the previous lecture. Now what happens for a DC amplifier if it does not have points for putting offset null circuitry? In such ICs, see here for IC307, we can see that there is an additional circuitry applied in all the three configurations. See, you can see for all the three configuration here and here an additional circuitry has been applied. So why this has been applied, this we'll see. For an op amp without offset null capability, the external offset voltage compensating network should be used. So 741 is internally compensating network device. It has offset null circuitry points where we can put a potentiometer and reduce the offset voltage to zero. In the operational amplifier which do not have such a facility, we have to connect an external circuit that will reduce the output offset voltage to zero. So these three show the that circuitry. Here this is the circuitry that has that is provided in order to reduce the output offset voltage to zero. Now if you do not wish to put this extra circuitry, then what you can do, you have to use a very high precise low offset output voltage op amp. In that case you'll have to use a better op amp. Otherwise a high precision op amp having smaller offsets and drifts must be used. So this is basically the DC amplifier, the way operational amplifier is used as a DC amplifier. Now we'll discuss the AC amplifier. So here this is a basic diagram of an AC amplifier, showing one figure you can see the input is connected at the inverting end, and in the other circuit diagram you can see that the input is connected to the non-inverting end. So the circuit, as you can see, these circuits are similar to the circuit shown before. So the circuit shown in earlier slides respond to AC input signals as well. However, there is one necessary thing. In order to use it as an AC amplifier, it is required to add a coupling capacitor. See here the basic difference between the previous figure and this figure is that there is an additional capacitor connected in the input. This capacitor is called coupling capacitor. So it is necessary to use an AC amplifier with the coupling capacitor in order to get AC response characteristics of the op amp. Now what does this coupling capacitor do? First of all, the coupling capacitor blocks the DC voltage, so no DC enters, only AC signal gets amplified. It also sets the lower frequency cutoff limits, and it helps to eliminate DC level amplification from stage to stage. If we are connected one stage to another stage, it prevents DC amplification. So DC level remains stable. So in this way, all other things, the functioning of this op amp is similar as we had discussed in case of operational amplifier inverting. We had discussed inverting amplifier and non-inverting amplifier in detail, with feedback, without feedback, all that. The behavior functioning is same, but we have, and the formulas are also the same, but we have applied an additional coupling capacitor to provide, so that it may get, we get a AC response characteristics of the op amp only. It basically blocks the DC. Now next application is the peaking amplifier. Now what is the peaking amplifier? Basically, the peaking amplifier is an amplifier that provides a peak signal. Now, what is a peak signal? See here. If we are required something like this, peak at a particular frequency, then this type of circuit can be used. So, the peaking response, that is, the frequency response peaks at a certain frequency. Peaks at a certain frequency, this means it is maximum at certain frequency, and then this amplifier that produces such a peak is known as peaking amplifier. And this diagram, as this circuit diagram, is the basically peaking amplifier. Now here you can see that we are providing input at inverting end, feedback is provided, and along with the feedback we have LC parallel circuit combination also connected in the feedback region. So the peaking response is the frequency response that peaks at a certain frequency, and it can be obtained by using a parallel LC network with the op amp. So you can see from the diagram, the peaking amplifier uses parallel LC network in the feedback path, and the output is shown by the figure second. The resonant or peak frequency, resonant frequency or peak frequency here, this is obtained by the help of L or C combination, and it is given by Fp is equals to 1 upon 2 pi under root L by C, and for this the Q condition should be greater than equal to 10. Now what is Q? Q is the figure of merit of the coil. Now the impedance of parallel LC network is very large at the resonant frequency, this we know. So the gain of the amplifier at resonance is maximum and is given by somewhat like this, minus RF parallel combination of RP upon R1. So this is the gain of the amplifier that is provided at the resonance. The impedance of the parallel LC network below and above the peak frequency is always less than RP. This is the basic condition of parallel LC network, that its impedance is maximum at resonance and it decreases on both sides. So the gain of the amplifier is less than RF RP upon R1 at any other frequency than FP. So what will happen? The gain will be maximum at the peak frequency, this resonant frequency, and it will drop down on both sides, either left hand side or right hand side, as you can see from the diagram. So this is basically peaking amplifier, the use of operational amplifier as a peaking amplifier. Now next we'll discuss, so now we'll discuss summing, scaling and averaging amplifier. Now summing, scaling and averaging amplifier can be obtained using operational amplifier either in inverting configuration, non-inverting configuration or differential configuration. So basically inverting, non-inverting and differential configurations can be used for summing, scaling and averaging applications. So we'll discuss one by one how a inverting configuration can be used as a summing, scaling or averaging amplification, how non-inverting configuration can be used and how a differential configuration can be used. We'll take one by one. So first of all, we'll discuss in this lecture, first of all, we'll discuss the inverting configuration. So what we will do, we will take up an inverting configuration and we'll see how this configuration can be used to sum up an input voltage or either average an input voltage. So the inverting configuration, as you can see, this is the basic diagram of an inverting configuration with three inputs. Now this circuit can be used as a summing amplifier, as a scaling amplifier or an averaging amplifier. First of all, we'll discuss this in general and then we'll specifically define it for all the three types. So as you can see from the figure, there are three inputs, 1, 2 and 3, VA, VB and VC. These are three inputs. Depending on the relationship between feedback resistor RF and the resistors RA, RB and RC, this circuit can be used as a summing amplifier, scaling amplifier or an averaging amplifier. So basically what is the relation between RF and RA, RB and RC is important here. Now first of all, we'll write Kirchhoff's current equation at V2. So there are three currents coming, IA, IB and IC coming, and there are two currents leaving, IB and IF. So we can write the equation IA plus IB plus IC is equals to IB plus IF. Now for an operational amplifier, it is known that the input resistance is infinite and its gain is also infinite. So this point behaves like a virtual ground, and because of this, the current flowing, because of the infinite input resistance, the current flowing in the operational amplifier is approximately zero. So IB will be approximately zero, and all the current that is coming from IA, IB, IC will go through IF. Also, because the gain is considered infinite, this means that the V1 minus V2, this is V1 and this is V2. So what is gain? Gain is output voltage upon input voltage. So output voltage is V0 upon input voltage is V1 minus V2 is equals to 1 upon 0. This we know. So 1 upon 0 because it is infinity. So what happens? The input voltage V1 minus V2 should be 0. Or we can say that V1 should be equal to V2, and because V1 is grounded, so V2 should also be 0. Or all this can be compiled in one sentence by saying that V2 is a virtual ground. So V2 is virtual ground. This means that V2 is 0 and IB current flowing through here is 0. All the current passes through IF. So this equation, current equation can be modified. Now we'll put the values of IA, IB, IC and IF using the figure. So what will be IA? Basically what will be IA? IA will be VA upon RA. What will be IB? VB upon RB. And what will be IC? VC upon RC. So, we can place the values of these. Now, we have to calculate IF. Now, IF will be the voltage here and voltage here. Here voltage is 0. Here voltage is V naught. So, current is flowing here. So, it is at higher potential and it is at lower potential. So, V2 minus V0 is equals to V2 minus V0 upon RF is equals to IF. So, because V2 is 0, this will be simply minus V0 upon RF. Now, we'll place all these values. So, we get this following equation. Now, we'll calculate V0. So, we get V0 in this way. So, this is the equation output of the output voltage that we can obtain from this circuit as shown in the figure. Now, I have previously said that by the suitable combination of RF, RA and RB, RB and RC, we can make this circuit for summing, and we can use this circuit for summing, scaling or averaging. So, we'll take one by one. Again, I have shown this diagram. And first of all, I'll take the summing amplifier. So, now, if in this circuit, in place of RA, RB, RC, I replace all three resistors by a same resistor R, then what happens? The previous equation will become somewhat like this. Because RA, RB, RC are now common, they will be come out, and simply V0 will be minus RF upon R, VA plus VB plus VC. This means that the output voltage is equal to the negative sum of all the inputs times the gain of the circuit. This is the gain of the circuit. RF upon R is simply the gain of the circuit. So, it is summing the inputs along with, and it is amplifying as multiplied by the gain. So, such a circuit is called a summing amplifier. But if you want to see that summing amplifier means simply adding the input voltage, then what we'll have to do? We'll have to make this gain equal to 1. So, when the gain of the circuit is 1, then what happens? In that case, RA, RB, RC should be equal to RF. So, RF upon RF will get cancelled, and simply the output voltage will be minus of VA plus VB plus VC. So, such a circuit, if RA, RB, RC and RF, all four resistors are of the same value, then this circuit can behave as a summing amplifier with a negative sum. It will give a negative sum. Now, next we'll discuss the scaling amplifier. Again, we'll take the same diagram and we'll discuss the scaling or weighted amplifier. So, what does this weighted means? Weightage, now you must have heard the term weightage. So, weightage means the each input is how much each input is given weightage to the output or is contributing to the output voltage. So, what we will see the amount of weightage that is provided to the output by the input, any input, that is the weightage. And so, this scaling or weighted amplifier is simply this thing. If each input is amplified by a different factor, so this will be amplified in a different way, this will be amplified in a different way, and this will be amplified in a different way. In that case, the amplifier is called a scaling or weighted amplifier. or we can say this that they are weighted differently. This condition can be accomplished if RA, RB, RC are all three are different in value. Thus, the output voltage will be simply as we have discussed previously. None of the resistors are equal, so we'll get output in such a way. Such an amplifier is simply a scaling or weighted amplifier. Here, it is necessary that RF upon RA is not equal to RF upon RB and is not equal to RF upon RC. In the next inverting configuration, we'll discuss averaging amplifier. Again, we have drawn the same diagram and we'll discuss the averaging amplifier. So how can we, what does the averaging amplifier means? Averaging means how do we calculate average? If we have three inputs, we add all the three inputs and divide by three. So in this way, we calculate the average. Here also, by suitable combination of resistors, we can make this circuit to behave, to give an output voltage which is average of the input voltage. This circuit can also be used as an averaging amplifier in which output voltage is equal to the average of all input voltages. This is accomplished if resistors RA, RB, RC all three are equal to R and the gain by which each input is amplified is equal over the number of inputs. So what does this mean? This means RF upon R is equals to 1 by N. What is N? N is the number of inputs. So by this diagram, we can discuss here how many inputs are there. There are three inputs. So small n will be equal to 3. So what is necessary in this circuit? RF upon R should be chosen in such a way that RF upon R is equals to 1 by 3. If such is such a way the resistors are chosen, then the circuit will behave as a averaging amplifier. Thus, if there are three inputs, we want RF upon RF, R is equals to 1 by 3. So, the output of voltage of the averaging amplifier is V0 equals to minus VA plus VB plus VC upon 3. Now, in this way, this circuit can behave as an averaging amplifier. Here, to remember, important thing to remember is RF upon R is equals to 1 upon N, where N is the number of inputs. Now, in all these figures of the inverting configuration, one thing you must have noticed that here also we have placed a resistor and its value is written as ROM. Now, what does this ROM means? The value of ROM has been calculated by such a combination. Now, what does this ROM means? This resistor is basically called the offset minimizing resistor, and it is used to minimize the effect of input bias currents on the output offset voltage. So basically, this is used to improve the working efficiency of the operational amplifier. Also, this resistor is used, but the offset voltage compensating network should also be used. This is an additional protection for better performance of the operational amplifier. So here in this lecture, we have discussed the DC amplifier, AC amplifier and summing, scaling, averaging amplifier using inverting configuration. In the next lecture, we'll discuss the non-inverting configuration and the differential configuration along with other applications, linear application of the operational amplifier. Thank you.